I'm in this place because I have the passion and the love for my country, for our people. For far too long, we have lived with a traditionally held belief that political leadership is reserved for certain class and certain age. And I dare to say that this belief has been held since the founding of this nation. And so potential young people, we sit, we cast our ballots for a certain class of people, and we live either with this inferiority complex or feel intimidated by the presence or the class of certain people. And my opinion, which can be proven right, is that the resources of our country is not being, the resources are not being equitably distributed and felt by the common people, poor people. For far too long, we have denied ourselves of this right to exercise sin. And my opinion again, I have this very strong belief that Liberia needs new energy, new dream, new vision. And that will only come when a new breed of honest leaders, young people with the potential, take over leadership in this country so as to put our country back on track and bring about the kind of a change, positive change, that our country so needs and our people so desire. It's so enticing, well made, well written. But I ask myself a question. Do they have the courage? Do they have the passion? Do they have the willpower and determination, those principles, to live by what they receive? Strongly in my ability, my capacity, and my principles to ensure the process that will lead us toward this end, whereby we begin to implement laws that are people-oriented, people-driven, that will impact the lives of our people. Corruption has engulfed this country, and I dare to say, since the founding of this country. But in my lifetime, I haven't seen corruption so rampant currently like it is, with no practical action being taken. Everything, especially under this administration, is being done selectively. Justice is being applied selectively. Employment is being done selectively, and you just name it. Liberia needs young, energetic, passionate, and honest leaders to take us there. Look at me, I'm 40 years old. Look at my normal time that the older generation has given me to live in. On our normal time, in our older generation, we are still flushing Komo with buckets. You want to see lights? You got to come on the road, on the streets, to see street lights. You want electricity at home? You got to purchase, find money to purchase a target generator. This is the kind of normal time we live in. And with no hope in sight that we're going to redeem ourselves from this kind of a primitive way of life. Simply because people lack the willpower, people lack the courage and the passion to ensure that these things are done. And so I dare this thing. This thing is about motivating other potential young people who are still sitting and feeling that it's not their time. This revolution is one that is intended to motivate young people to wake up. That if Darius Dylan, even in the face of his shortcomings and limited capacities, can make it, I too, as a young person of this generation, can make it. Let me wake up. Let me wake up in the interest of our country so that together we can make it. I believe that the Bible is right when it says, where there's no vision, the people perish. We have the vision. It is the authority we seek to ensure that these visions are implemented. And are there, and even in the face of all of the odds, most of these people in the race, if not all, apart from this Darius Dillon, since 2005 has risen to the plate. We have dared to speak against the LC Society. We have spoken to every issue that tend not to benefit our people. When all of these people in the race, apart from this Darius Dillon, were sleeping because they had not seen an opening that they want to enjoy, they were sleeping. We were taking the risk, going to jail, speaking at the peril of our job, and the people feel that even without an opportunity, change will not come in the morning when Darius Dillon takes over office in the evening. But the process of change will begin with the unbending principles that we have, and with the character, the strong moral character that we bring to the table strongly, that change will come to this country in time. Barack Obama is president of America today, not because his name is Barack Obama or because he went to Harvard. Barack Obama, a black man, is president of white America today because an awareness campaign was launched some 40 odd years ago by the legs of Martin Luther King that have gotten Barack Obama to the presidency of America today. Our people will see change, but it must begin from somewhere. And with the passion and the determination we have, we believe strongly that the process that leads up there will begin when we enter the Senate. Over the years, our people have followed our track record. And I'm proud to say, as a young person, we have managed our lives well, even in the face of the difficulties. And I want to encourage young people to see me as a fine example. Life has not been easy. Still, it's not easy. People get to know my life story, how difficult it was. And with determination, by the grace of God, the blessing of God, that we can make it, other potential young people, even in the face of difficulties, can make it. They just need to be determined and wake up, make realize that they have potential and make themselves relevant. Interestingly, I hear people running after my academic standing. And this is laughable. I value education. That is why, even with my meager resources, I'm sponsoring over 68 students, non-registered voters, underprivileged children in school. I've got my son in college, where I could not reach, where I may not reach, in terms of academic qualification. I want people, children, I want my children, to transcend that level. Education is acquisition of skill. It can be formal, it can be informal. But it is also safe to say academic education is not all to it. Leadership, the wisdom from God, is also a key factor in governing people. I'm a proud 1989 graduate of West Heston High School. I don't know why people are just lazy to stroll down to the school. That school was not burned during the war. Documents are intact. The school authority has spoken. They have confirmed that Darius Dillon is a product of that school. But some spineless political figure who do not have anything materially substantive to dent my chances of winning this election, just use this as a smear campaign, and it's just laughable. But we want to urge, Barack Obama is 47 years old and he's ruling the world, America. Nicolas Sarkozy is in his 40s. Vladimir Putin from Russia is in his 40s. It is only in Liberia and some part of Africa that people in the 70s won't retire and gave the younger generation the time and the opportunity to begin the process of bringing in new vision and new energy. And this thing is about awakening the young people that it is our time and we must get it. And with determination, we shall win.
Thank you very much, Mr. Dillon.